So I've talked a lot about what I've learned. So where is the future going? What is the next transition going to be? So from a technology perspective, one of the things I always talk about, opportunities for people in this room, is the transition that we are going to make with the internet. Making the internet more of a platform for collaboration, not just messaging, more of a platform for video and media experience, more of a platform to change healthcare, platform to change energy, platform to create smart communities, a platform to provide sustainability. Think about all the transitions that we will have, building that technology, commercializing that technology, and creating innovation that surrounds that growth. Think about how much personal growth each of us can capitalize from that. So there have been many women leaders before me that have been role models for me, and they have paved the way for us to reach where we are at today. While they created the path for us to follow, I think the generation of leaders that are going to come behind us will have a very different journey. So I want to now talk a little bit about the changing role of women leaders, especially for those that are here, that are students and younger women that are here who will be shaping the future for us many years from today. How will the role of women leaders, probably applies to all leaders, change in the future? So if you think about women in technology up until this point, the words typically that come to mind are pioneer, trailblazer, different, solo, teacher. And they're all great traits, because those were the traits that we needed at the time for women to be visible and to lead in technology. How will that change in the future? What will be some new skills we have to add to that? So in addition to being a pioneer, it is more and more important for a leader in the future to have the ability to increase their sphere of influence. We're just talking about Twitter and Facebook. I don't know where Nora went. You know, she was talking about how women shoot themselves in their foot by doing the wrong thing. But you know what? That can be a hugely powerful tool. Look at what President Obama did during his campaign. He used social media in addition to the traditional media like TV and newspapers. He used things like Facebook, Twitter, my personal favorite, wikis, blogs, anything you can get. And the point is that there are all these tools available now for us to have that influence that I was talking about earlier. And that's a delicate skill. How much of your personal self do you share, and how much do you not share? Now, when you're an executive in a big company, people take anything you say, and sometimes out of context, so you have to be careful how much you share about your personal self. If you're not personal, you will lose the sphere of influence because people will just see you as a PR for the company, right? And they will lose interest because they want to get to know you, who you are as a person. They want you to be authentic. So this is a new skill that we all have to develop, and the leaders of the future will have to leverage this. The second thing, if you think about leaders of the past, they were trailblazers. Leaders of the future, in addition to blazing a trail, have to figure out how to create a community to follow that trail. We belong to many communities, right? I belong to a community of women engineers. I belong to a community of moms. I belong to a community of Chicagoans. I belong to a community of Asian Americans. I belong to a community of Bay Area techies. I belong to a community of Cisco engineers. There are many communities we belong to, and sometimes these communities overlap. And the new skill is going to be to try to figure out when do we merge these communities and when do we separate them? That's the new balance or the integration that's going to be the challenge for the future. The third thing, if you think about what women had to do in the past, we were told to be different. Women had to be different to be noticed. We were told to talk different. We were told to act different. Sometimes we were even told to dress different. I think that notion has to change in the future. Women have to be women to be great leaders. Especially when times are tough, people are looking for leaders that are authentic, that are open, that are approachable, that are transparent, that feel human. And I think this is something that is going to be a skill. Some of us have to unlearn what we were taught, and some of us have to be who we are to be successful in the future. Third thing is, in the past, people worked alone. A successful leader had his or her domain. We kind of, you know, developed a personality that we projected out, and we worked alone. That notion's going away. The future is all about collaboration. The future, like I said, is very complex. We have to cross boundaries. We have to figure out how to partner with our competitors. We compete with a company, then you're partnering with that company. It's very complicated. And you're doing business globally in many countries, and all economies are interconnected. When one economy goes down, everything is affected. You can't work alone anymore. You have to figure out how to collaborate. And for that, that's a special skill. Collaboration is even different from teamwork. Collaboration means when I don't even know, I'm just formulating an idea, I'm willing to share that. That means I'm telling you I'm vulnerable. I don't know all the answers. Oh my gosh, you're the CTO and you don't know all the answers? Wow. I tell people, no, CTO's job is not to know all the answers, it's to know how to ask the right questions. So there. So you have to show that you're vulnerable, because only then will you get the right input for people to collaborate and work with you. And I think those are some things that I feel are very important for the future. The other thing that as leaders we have to be comfortable with for the future, in the past we were teachers. We gave instructions, we were prescriptive about what people needed to do. In the future, it's about sharing experiences. It's coming out here and letting my fears be silent so that I can share with you my passions tonight. I hope someday you will do that. I hope every day you will do that. I hope every day you will put your fears aside and share your passion with others from your experience, what you feel are important. So now, without any hesitation, I want to say thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak with you.